Back on the river, folks, get with our old, you know, with our old rig. This bobber here just came off the drying rack. Remember, I lost a couple last week. Made some new ones, actually decided to paint them this time, that lime green. And one of the things you do with a bobber, especially these that I make, is that, you know, each one is a little bit different. And so you have to judge the cocking weight. Now, what is the cocking weight? It's the bare minimum amount of weight it takes to make the bobber stand up. And so this is just kind of a quick tip. And so what you do is you just get out here, put your weight on there, put it off in the water, and just see. Still requires the same amount of weight there. I'm finding that these bobbers in general just need a single number 3 split shot lead, and that's all you really need. Now, just because most of them need that doesn't mean that all of them are going to need that. Some of them may need a little bit more, some of them may need a little bit less. So it just depends on what you're doing and how you're doing it. So if you're ever putting on a new bobber of any kind, always test the cocking weight first. And see, bam, it just cocks right up there. And you see that bobber is right there on that balance point. You see it balances right there. And that's why I like it. It's the bare minimum amount of weight for doing that. And we can do a test cast here. Good to go. All right. Another tip is to make sure you cast it out and reel it back in to see if the slip shot weight itself moves. Because you don't want that slip shot moving, because that'll abrade your line, and especially when we're doing ultralight stuff. You want to be able to put that split shot on there and let it stay right there. And you need to just adjust that. So you know, a couple of test casts, you know, and just see if it'll move. If it stays where it put, then you're good to go. All right.